Okay, shall I start? I was here. I obtained the magnitude. First, I founded the principal planes, planes on which the shear stress are maximum. Planes on which the shear stress are maximum, θs1 and θs2. And then I substituted this θs1 and θs2 to the tangential shear stress expression, sigma t. I got the magnitude of shear stress, tau max or tau minimum. Only the sign changes, magnitude remains the same. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus or minus sigma x plus sigma y by 2. But if you can see here, when I substituted theta s1 is equal to 45 degree in sigma 2 max, I got sigma t is equal to minus sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Since there is a negative sign here, according to our sign convention, it will rotate our s1 phase in clockwise direction. It will rotate, that is the S1 phase, it will rotate S1 plane or S1 phase, in clockwise direction. Our sign convention was anti-clockwise, like this. This is the plane, this is the x-axis. If this is in the upward anti-clockwise, this is rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, then it would have been positive sign convention. This will be okay. This will be other. We will not discuss this. It's only the same. If this is positive, we'll talk about x-axis. In case if this arrow is like this, this is x-phase. This arrow is like this. This will rotate the element in a clockwise direction. This anti-clockwise is positive. It will rotate the elements in clockwise direction. This is negative. Since sigma t is with negative sign, it will rotate the S1 phase in clockwise direction. Okay, keeping that in mind, and we also need to find sigma origin. Planes of maximum shear stress are also accompanied with average stress and normal stresses, whereas the planes of maximum normal stresses are not accompanied with shear stresses. Planes of maximum stresses are accompanied with average stresses and normal stresses. Okay. To find the average or normal stresses, average stresses acting on the planes of maximum shear stress. Planes of maximum shear stress, θ s1 is equal to 45 degree from the x-axis, θ s2 is equal to 135 degree from the x-axis. So we know that sigma t, in order to find the sigma n, there is a place of maximum average stress, there is normal stress. I need to substitute θ s1 is equal to 45 in sigma n. I need to substitute θ s2 is equal to 135 in the sigma n. Both leads to the same expression, same results. Okay. Sigma n is given by sigma 1 is given as sigma n. I will write it here. Sigma n, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sine 2 theta for theta s1. For theta s1 is equal to 45 degree, you can check sigma n is equal to sigma average, which is equal to sine 2 theta sine 90, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2, which is equal to sigma average, is equal to minus minus, it will cancel. It is equal to sigma x, right? It is equal to sigma x, right? Sigma over h, sorry, sigma y by 2, sigma y by 2 cancels, and sigma t, is this sigma anything we have done? Sigma over h, it has shown. Sigma x, this is cos theta, Andre. You should tell me, Alva. This is the sine to cos 2 theta. I'm committing the same mistake. They're also not noticing. This is cos 2 theta. Cos 2 theta, cos 90. This cos 90 to be 0. Therefore, cos 90, cos 90 to be 0. This will be equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Similarly, for theta s 2 is equal to 135 degree, sigma n is equal to sigma over h, which is equal to cos 270 is how much? 135 into 2, it should be 0, sigma over h, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Cos 270 is 0. So sigma over h given the same sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Now, first, in order to represent that, first let us write the xy plane with reference to this plane. With reference to this plane, for the given state of stress condition, this is a biaxial state of stress condition. If I rotate my x-axis at an angle 45 degree, then I will get theta s1, and at an angle 90 degree to it, it will be theta s2. So how to represent it? First, if see here, theta s1 is at an angle 45 degree. So in for representing that, I'll take a line. At an angle 45 degrees, since theta is measured anticlockwise positive, this is theta s1 is equal to 45 degree. This is my s1 plane. Okay, perpendicular to it will be s2 plane. This is s2 plane. As usual, write the plane. I got the faces. Write the plane. These are the planes. This is the plane. Okay. Normal to this S1 and S2 phase. Now, on this phase, tau is of magnitude. I can, where is tau? Magnitude of tau. You find the magnitude of tau, right? To find the average stresses, sigma t max. Tau is of magnitude. Sigma t max is nothing but plus or minus sigma x y by 2. So before that, according to our sign convention, theta S1 is equal to 45 degree. It will rotate S1 phase in clockwise direction. Okay, on S1 phase, I should write that clockwise direction. Okay. Give me a moment. Okay. -sigma x - sigma y/2. Sine 2 theta is 1. Okay. So, if you see here, the theta S1, it will rotate S1 phase in clockwise direction. So, you should represent tau. This will rotate my, this is S1 phase. It will rotate S1 phase in clockwise direction. S1 phase in clockwise direction. This is my, if I write tau or sigma t max, tau max, if you write whatever, this one the same, and opposite to it, it should be like this, and it should be like this, arrow should meet, and it should be like this, and indicate the magnitude. Magnitude is nothing but same, and this phase is nothing but sigma x minus sigma y by 2. This is magnitude indicated here, anywhere, sigma x minus sigma y by 2. And all four faces, magnitude remains the same. And this face is minus sigma x by 2, and this face is plus sigma y by 2. Nothing to worry. Indicate sigma x minus sigma y by 2. And also, you can see here, there is an average stress given by sigma x. There is a normal stress given by sigma x plus sigma y by 2. There is also a normal stress acting whose magnitude is of sigma x plus sigma y by 2. I have to indicate sigma over h, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2, or you can indicate an average stress throughout like this, sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Similarly, on this face, sigma x, so it has to be here. You can draw neatly on this face. On this face, sigma x plus sigma y by 2. On this face also, sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Okay, that completes your entire thing. We have found the planes on which the stresses play of principal stresses are present, and we have found the magnitude of principal stresses. We have found the planes for maximum shear stresses. We have found the magnitude of maximum shear stress, minimum shear stress. We have found the average shear stresses. Okay, so in this problem, for this biaxial state of stress condition, we have found the maximum and minimum stress. This is the stress condition. Okay, in order to obtain the maximum, minimum and principal stress, I have taken some plane at an angle certain angle theta, and I have derived it. Okay, in case, for example, if I want to know the stress on this plane B, for example, this theta is at an angle of what? Assume that is an angle of 30 degree. Then I can write directly, I can go to sigma n. If I substitute the value of 30 degree here, I will be getting sigma n for this plane. If I substitute the value of 30 degree, I will be getting sigma t on that plane B, normal and tangential force, which is nothing but axial and shear stress on that plane B. Okay, hope you understood this. I will stop at this point. You can ask me if you have any doubts. Okay. Okay, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear? As simple, if you resolve the forces, your 50 to 60% work is done. That's right for resolving the forces. And that if you have done, you can do by yourself. Have you understood this? Tell me first. Have you understood this? How procedurally I have done this, starting from the scratch? I will once again tell you, I'll go back and I'll, any of you don't have the third o'clock class, right? So resolve the forces along the normal and tangential direction. Find the planes of maximum principal stress, theta p1, theta p2. We have found theta p1, theta p2, and substitute theta p1 and theta p2 in sigma n to get sigma 1, sigma 2. We have done this to find sigma 1, sigma 2. Similarly, we have find the planes of maximum shear stress. Sometimes planes of maximum shear stress or planes of maximum principal stress or minimum principal stress can be found out by directly by inspection. If there is 2 theta, sine 2 theta, if I substitute 2 theta is equal to 90 degree, I'll get directly sine is equal to 1, there is a maximum value. Some, if it is with some expression, something like expression as we solved in this case, it is not possible to easily derive it. Then you have to say that if my first derivative is equal to zero, it is assumed that my second derivative will be negative. So the second derivative will be negative. So this is the maximum value. And then fourth, I can substitute equal to zero, I can find the values. Similarly, I can find the planes of maximum shear stress. And after finding the planes of maximum shear stress, I will substitute these values into my sigma t expression. I will find sigma t max and sigma minimum. Also, to know the direction of sigma t, to know whether it's clockwise or anti-clockwise, I cannot just put an arrow like this or like this. To know the direction of sigma t, what I have to do, I have to see the sign when I substitute theta as 1 to sigma t, whether it's positive or negative. If it is positive, it rests the S1 facing counterclockwise direction. If it is negative, it rests the S1 facing clockwise direction. Okay, after that, the maximum shear stress planes are also accompanied with average stress, there is a normal stress. In order to find that, I need to substitute theta s1 and theta s2 into sigma n. Why sigma n? This is a normal stress, this is a tangential stress. So sigma, if I substitute here, I will get the magnitude of sigma average. Okay, I'll stop at this point. Any doubts, you can ask me. Okay, I'll be evaluating your internal paper today or tomorrow. Okay, I'll send you the results. Any doubts, you can ask me. I'll stop at this point. Shall I stop at this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.